சார் லிங்க் கரெக்டாக இருக்கு சார். நான் ஒரு
ஓகே சார். ஓகே சார், நீங்க உங்க ஃப்ரீ ஐடி நீங்க வாங்க, நான் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸை வந்துட்டு மெசேஜ் பண்ணி அசம்பிள் பண்ணிடுறேன் சார்.
ஓகே
மீட்டிங்
சார்.
ரெக்கார்ட் பண்ணிக்கிறேன், நீங்க அப்படியே கண்டினியூ பண்ணி ஒரு 7:30 போல முடிச்சிருங்க சார்.
ஓகே சார்.
ஓகே சார், ஓகே.
குட் ஈவினிங் சார்.
குட் ஈவினிங் சார். குட் ஈவினிங். குட் ஈவினிங்
பிலால் சார்.
சொல்லுங்க சார். ரெடி சார் நானு.
நீங்க ஓகே சார், யூ கேன் ஸ்டார்ட் சார். ஐ வில் இன்ஃபார்ம் தி ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ், ஸ்டூடண்ட்ஸ் வில் ஜாயின் ரேண்டம்லி சார்.
ஓகே சார், நோ ப்ராப்ளம் சார்.
ஓகே சார், நான் ரெக்கார்டிங் போட்டுருக்கேன் சார், அதனால நீங்க அப்படியே கிளாஸ்
நான் அட்மிட் பண்ணுமா சார் இல்ல நான் பர்மிட் பண்ணுமா?
இல்ல நான் அவங்க டொமைன்ல இருக்கனால அவங்க வந்துருவாங்க சார். நீங்க கிளாஸ் கம்ப்ளீட் பண்ணிட்டு யூ கேன் மைண்ட் அப் திஸ் சார். தட்ஸ் ஆல்.
ஓகே சார். ஓகே சார், தேங்க்ஸ்.
ஓகே சார். ஓகே ஓகே.
Just a moment, I will share my screen, then you can proceed. Okay, good evening everyone. Can you able to see my screen?
Yes sir. Yes sir.
Yeah, okay. Oops. So in previous lecture, actually I handled the lecture some 20-15 days before. So I just give a recap in a couple of minutes, then you can move to the problem area, illustrative problem area that you have asked in the previous class itself. So we started the phase relationship topic in the previous session, which is based in a geotechnical engineering. It will be helpful for both soil mechanics as well as foundation engineering related problems. So for that reason we have taken so much time to explain those basic concepts. So in that first we discussed about the phase diagram. So in general, soil can be termed as a three-phase system. We can call a partially saturated soil as a three-phase system in which all three phases of matter, that's solids, liquid and air, all three will be present. And then for a completely dry soil, which is a one extreme case, there will not be any water present, only the white spaces will be filled with only by air. That is one category, one extreme case. And another extreme case where the soil is fully saturated, in that case the soil, the white spaces in the soil will be filled by water alone. So these two extreme cases we can call as a two-phase system. In these two extreme cases we can call the soil as a two-phase system. And we have seen the basic formulas and relationships regarding this in regard with this phase relationship. There is a water content or moisture content which is expressed by the small letter W, and it is expressed in percentage. and the range for water content is it can be more than zero. It cannot be equal to zero, but it can be more than zero. But actually, that equal to or greater than zero, that parameter is a bit arguable one. But for all practical cases, we are taking water content as more than zero, and there is no upper limit for it. Okay. So the next parameter we discussed about void ratio, which is expressed as E, and it is usually given in decimal, fraction value or decimal value. There won't be any percentage involved in that. So the again, the range for void ratio is also, it is greater than zero. Void ratio, it cannot be equal to zero. Okay, the reason being, the volume of voids can never be equal to zero. If it is equal to zero in some substance, then we should call it as a solid substance, completely solid substance. We cannot call it as a soil. We can either call it as a rock, okay, because soil, in the basic definition of a soil, it is a collection of sediment. Okay, it is not a solid matter alone. Okay, so it is a collection of weathered sediments. Weathering, you know about weathering in you could have studied that in your applied or engineering geology, whatever given in your curriculum. Maybe either you can term the paper as applied geology or engineering geology. So in that, you could have studied about that weathering phenomenon, and that is a source of this formation of soil. So in this basic definition, we can term the soil as a collection of sediments. We cannot call it as a solid matter alone. Okay, so keeping that in mind, we cannot make or the why not again, we cannot presume that volume of voids could be zero for a soil. Okay, so considering that, the volume of void ratio can never be zero. It can be more than zero. Okay, the next one, porosity, another parameter which describes the denseness or looseness of a soil. But in this case, we are considering the total volume of soil instead of only considering the volume of solid. Okay, so here we are going to consider the total volume of soil. Okay, so N, it is expressed in, usually expressed in percentage, and the range of N, it could be, it could lie between 0 to 100, excluding those two numbers, 0 and 100. It can be anywhere between 0 to 100. Okay, you should not include 0 or 100 in that range. Okay, please keep that in mind. Because as far as this MCQs are related, MCQs concern, the options are going to be like this, whether it is greater than 0, greater than or equal to 0, less than 0, less than or equal to 0. The options are going to be spread out like this. So you have to be very, very clear in your thinking or memory, whatever. Okay, so you should be clear in that. So porosity, the range is 0 to between 0 to 100. Okay, not from 0 to 100. Okay, keep that in mind. Next, the parameter we discussed is a degree of saturation. So here the range is 0, including 0 and 100. Both cases are possible, and those two extreme cases which we have which we were discussing some time before, those fully dry soil and completely saturated soil, those two cases are going to affect in this particular parameter, degree of saturation parameter. For completely dry soil, the degree of saturation, it is going to be zero. Okay, because there won't be any volume of water in that. Okay, for a completely or for a fully saturated soil, the volume of voids is going to be occupied entirely by the volume of or water. Okay, so in that case, the VW becomes VV. Okay, VV, VW equals VV. So in that case, the degree of saturation can be 100. Mathematically, you can see that. Okay, both numerator and denominator going to be same, and hence the final result is going to be 100%. So for degree of saturation, the range is 0 to 100, including both those two values. Okay, it will be from 0 to 100. Please keep that in mind, and take these two extreme cases into account. the dry soil case and a fully saturated soil case. Okay, please keep that in mind. Okay, next one, air content. Okay, the opposite one of degree of saturation, we can call it like that. So in degree of saturation we are considering the volume of water into account, and in air content we are considering the volume of air into account. Okay, so VA divided by VV. So mathematically you can array air content in other ways like this, by means of 1 minus S. You can put that and you can get the value of AC. And another term, percentage air voids. Here the total volume is taken into account. So to arrive NA, the other way is like this, N into AC. You can multiply the porosity value and the air content, you will get the percentage air voids value. Okay, so all these things we discussed in the previous session itself. I'm just giving a recap. Okay, so here some of the interrelationships we discussed in the previous class. Some volume weight definitions, and then we discussed the interrelationships here. For definitions, bulk unit weight or bulk density, if you express in terms of Newton per meter cube, then we can call it as bulk unit weight. If you express in terms of mass, we have to call it as density. We usually do the same thing in fluid mechanics also. Okay, in fluid mechanics also we do the same thing. For density we use mass. Okay, for unit weight, or you can call as a specific weight in fluid mechanics, we use the weight of the substance. Okay, the final answer is going to be in newtons, newton per meter cube. Okay, so for bulk unit weight or bulk density, we are going to consider the total weight into account. So W by V for bulk unit weight, and M by V, that is mass by volume, for bulk density. The answer is going to be in kilonewton per meter cube for unit weights, and kg per meter cube for density values. Either kg per meter cube or gram per cc or ton per cc, whatever. I'm sorry, ton per meter cube, whatever. Okay, just keep that into account. Next, for dry unit weight, we will consider only the weight of the solid particles. Okay, we already discussed three states of matter are present in soil, and in those three states we are only considering the solid matter alone. Okay, solid particles alone, the weight of solid particles alone. Okay, if you ask me, is it possible to measure the weight of solid particles in soil separately? It is very, very simple. Okay, you can keep that soil in a oven for 24 hours. You take the weight in the next day, you will get the weight of solids alone. All the water matter present in the soil is going to be going to get evaporated, leaving the structural water alone. The structural water present in soil means the water which is helpful in creating the bond between a soil particle. Okay, inside a soil particle actually. Okay, excluding the structural water, all the other pore waters or the waters present in the voids, it will be evaporated in that oven drying process. But to eliminate the structural water, we have to increase the temperature to much larger degrees. But usually that is not necessary. Okay, and for measuring the weight of solids alone, that is not necessary. Okay, so you don't need to go much deeper in that. Okay, here measurement of weight of solids is much easier. Okay, so if we take the weight of solids due to be volume, we will get the dry unit weight of the soil. Next one, saturated unit weight. You measure the weight of soil in its saturated condition, then you divide it by volume of the soil, you will get the saturated unit. Actually, you can say it as you have to write this in this manner, like I have mentioned here. Actually, you have to write the gamma sat in this manner, not like this, because we don't have any term like W sat and all. Okay, actually this is not a correct manner. You have to write or express the saturated unit weight in this manner. W, put it in bracket and put the saturated as a suffix. Okay, because actually W sat is not a term we are usually using in a three-phase diagram. Okay, for that case we have to use or express the saturated unit weight in this manner. Okay, right. So it is nothing but the bulk density of a soil in its saturated condition. We can call it as a saturated density or saturated unit weight. That's it, nothing more than that. Submerged on the next extreme case in a soil, okay? So if a soil mass is completely submerged inside a water, then you can call it as a submerged. If we measure that unit rate, then we can term it as a submerged unit rate. In previous session itself, I have elaborately given the difference between a saturated soil mass and a submerged soil mass. Okay, the those two are totally different terms. Please keep that in mind. Both of them are not the same. Okay, for instance, considering our current weather conditions, we can say if you see rain drenched soil, you can call it as a saturated soil. If you see some rainwater getting stagnated somewhere, the soil beneath that stagnated rainwater, you can call it a submerged case. I hope you can understand the difference in that way. Okay, so we can call all submerged soils as saturated soils. Okay, but not all the saturated soils are submerged. You can take this as a phrase or metaphor, whatever you want. But please keep this in mind. I'll repeat once again. All submerged soils are saturated. Okay. But not all saturated soils are submerged. Okay. Please keep that in mind. So for a soil to attain the submerged state, it has to first pass through the saturated state, then only we can call it as the next stage it is going to get submerged. We have to see in that way. Okay, right? We have discussed this specific gravity term, the interrelationships between all the previously discussed definitions. We have seen everything in the previous session. Today we will pass through the problematic area, the illustrative problems, the problems which we usually get in any exams or tests. Okay, can move to that area. This one. Yeah. So here I have a general problem. Actually, for a competitive exam, you may get any one property. You may be asked to answer any one property which we are going to discuss in this problem. As a common to get an idea about all the property, how to solve a sum for all, how to solve a sum, I have discussed all the properties so far we have discussed in this particular sum. Okay, I have taken this sum in that considering those things to get an idea how to solve each property. Okay, so please look into this. A wet sample weighing 23 newtons had a volume of 1150 centimeter cube. After oven drying, its weight is reduced to 19.6 newtons. The specific gravity of the solids was found to be 2.65. Okay, when you read a problem in any subject, okay, as a matter of fact, in any subject, if you read a problem, you have to extract the data from it a part by part. If you do that correctly, then it is going to be much easier for you to complete the entire problem. So in this first statement itself, totally there are four different datas. You have to name it clearly what are those data given there. So a wet sample weighing 23 newtons. So stop till that and try to extract the information. What is the information given there? Okay, so wet sample means what are the two things that is going to contribute in the weight of the soil mass? If you can, you can please answer. So we know very well that a soil is a three-phase system. It contains solids, liquid, and air. All three matters are going to present in a soil mass. But if you take the weight property or mass property, for instance, of a soil, it is going to be contributed only by the solids and water. The air volume which is present in soil, it is not going to do much contribution to its self weight. Okay, hope you can understand. The weight of the soil is contributed only by this two portions. Okay, solid portion and the liquid portion will only contribute in its weight. The air portion, it is going to, well, it will have some contribution, but it is very, very negligible. We all know very well that the weight of the air. Okay, considering the weight of solids and the water present in the soil, the weight of air is very, very negligible. And hence, in this first line, a wet sample weighing 23 newtons means this 23 newtons is going to be contributed by both the solid portion and the liquid portion. For instance, water in our case. Okay, so the solids portion and the water portion, it is going to give this 23 newtons for that soil. Okay, that is the first data, solids plus water, the weight is 23 newtons. You have to get that, write the data in that manner. Okay, simply if you write weight 23 newton, you will get stuck in the next line, because in the next statement we are going, they are going to give another weight data. Okay, you will be get stuck in that area. Okay, so you have to very you have to split the question information in a detailed way. Okay, so now you not only look into the numerical part, please look into the text part also. Okay, please keep that in mind.
Yes, ma'am.
I got some message or something like that. Let's see. They got any message? Okay, nothing. Okay, we shall proceed. Okay, listen. So, a wet sample means solid matter plus water, in total it is going to contribute 23 newtons weight. Okay, the second data given is had a volume 1150 centimeter cube. It's not going to affect much, so we can take it as total volume V, because we don't have any other volume terminology in this particular problem, particular sum. So we need not to worry about any other volume given there or not. So we don't have any other volume given here, so we can take it as total volume V 1150 centimeter cube. After woven drying, its weight is reduced to 19.6 newtons. What is this? After woven drying, its weight is reduced to 19.6 means from 23 newtons, the weight is getting reduced to 19.6 newtons. What is the portion, or what is leaving from the soil so that its weight is getting reduced to 19.6 here? Can you say it? What is making the difference here?
Water.
Water. So after woven drying, the water is getting to be expelled or evaporated from the soil mass, and hence its volume is getting its weight is getting reduced to 19.6 newton. From this two statements itself, they can get the weight of water which was present in the original condition. Okay, so if we subtract that wet sample weight 23 newton and after woven drying weight 19.6 newton, we can easily get the weight of water present in the soil. So this is the way you have to extract the hidden information given in the problem. Okay, right. So you can note down it as weight of solids alone 19.6 newtons. So in previous weight, we have written as weight of solids plus water. Here only weight of solids. By means of subtracting this words as well as their numerical counterparts, we can easily get the weight of water. Okay, right. Just like we are doing x plus y plus z and so on, simultaneous equation in mathematics, we are going here, we are considering solids plus water, and in the second statement solids alone. So by means of subtracting those two, we are going to get the water part. You have to deal a problem in this way. Okay, right. The next information given is the specific gravity of solids was found to be 2.65. Okay, so here they are mentioning about G, okay, specific gravity G. So fluid mechanics, we use the letter capital S for this. Usually in fluid mechanics, we use the specific gravity terminology. There we used to denote specific gravity in terms of capital S, but here we are we have given that label for degree of saturation. So for that case, we have to use capital G and suffix S, or sometimes capital G alone, for denoting the specific gravity of solids. Okay, so why I am insisting this again and again means some students, when they face an exam which contains questions from all the fluid mechanics, questions from fluid mechanics part, so strength of materials part, soil mechanics part, they get confused which term is for denotes which property. Okay, so please know this difference. So for in fluid mechanics, we use S to denote specific gravity, but here we are already using that S letter for denoting the degree of saturation. So for the purpose, we are giving capital G for denoting specific gravity of solids. Please keep that in mind. Okay, this is the given data part. Okay, you have to get the exact information in this manner. Okay, next, determine water content, bulk unit weight, dry unit weight, saturated unit weight, effective unit weight, void ratio, porosity, degree of saturation. So actually there are 8 subdivisions in this problem. Okay, so when you face a competitive exam, any exam, say GATE exam or TNPSC or UPSC, whatever, they will be asking either one, or for a tougher question, say for a tumor problem, they may ask 2 properties at the maximum. That's it. Okay, they won't be expecting 8 properties from you, unless you are going to attend for the conventional exam or descriptive type exam of the UPSCs. Till that, in the screening exams or level 1 exams, you will be facing only multiple choice questions. So in that case, you will get at the maximum, they will be asking you 2 properties, or for much simpler questions, they will ask just 1 property from this. But to get a clear idea of how to arrive at a property from different properties, I have taken this sum for this class. Okay, so keeping this 4 parameters, we are going to find this all 8 properties in this particular sum. Okay, so we have, I have written the given data here. So the weight is 23 newtons. So the weight denotes weight of solids and weight of water, both are present there. Okay, so the next 19.6 newton is weight of solids alone. So by means of subtracting these 2, we will get the weight of water WW. Can calculate that in the next step. Okay, the volume given 1150 centimeter cube. So for solving this problem, we may convert the centimeter cube unit into a meter cube unit, because usually in soil mechanics, apart from lab experiments, in field experiments, field experiments or field situations, usually the soil mass is going to be in huge quantity. Okay, so mostly soil mechanics problem, we use the unit meter cube as a base unit. Okay, and even we prefer tons for denoting the mass instead of kilogram or gram like that. Okay, so but in case of lab, we use grams and centimeter cube, etc. But for practical situations, as far as soil mechanics is concerned, we use tons to denote the mass and the meter cube to denote the volume. Okay, so we can convert the centimeter cube term into meter cube by means of multiplying 10 power minus 6. 1 centimeter, if you convert into meter, it will be into 10 power minus 2. We have a cubes here, 3 centimeters here, 3 dimensional quantity here. So it will become 10 power minus 6. If we multiply 1150 by 10 power minus 6, we can convert this centimeter cube unit into meter cube unit. We will do that directly in the problem itself. Okay, so since you are in final year, the unit conversion is won't bother you much, I think. I hope. Okay, let's move into the problem. So first property they have asked is the water content. We know the basic definition or basic formula of water content, WW divided by WS, which means the weight of water divided by weight of solids. Okay, so I have to reiterate one thing here. So please don't get confused with these two parameters, water content and degree of saturation. Please don't get confused with these two parameters. In one parameter, we will take the weight properties into account. That is water content. For degree of saturation, we take the volume parameters into account. Okay, you can see the difference, both difference in this problem itself. Okay, so first we are discussing the water content area. Just a minute, I got some message or something like that. Yeah, okay, just a notification done. Right, let's proceed. So water content, WW by WS, as I already said, to get the weight of water, we can subtract the weight of soil in its wet state and its woven dry state. As you already said, the thing that is going to be excluded when the soil gets woven dry is water. Okay, so from that we can get the weight of water. So 23 minus 19.6, okay, divided by the weight of solids 19.6. If you do the calculations, we get 17.35%. Okay, right. The next property is bulk unit weight. We know the basic definition, total weight divided by volume. Okay, so put those values. So total weight is 23 newtons. We are converting into kilonewton. Okay, as I already said, usually we take tons units or kilonewton units. If we have to discuss about mass, we use ton units. If you have to discuss in terms of weight, we use kilonewton units. Very simple why we are doing these things, because if we use newton instead of kilonewton here, the answer is going, the number of digits in the answer is going to be much more. Okay, in order to reduce that, we are using kilonewton, nothing else. Okay, mathematically we can say like this, or practically you can take my previous answer, because the soil mass we are going to deal in practical situation is going to be very, very huge. Okay, right. So that is the reason. Right. Okay, let's move into the problem. So gamma B, the formula is total weight divided by volume. So here we have, you have to take the bulk condition, that is wet condition of the soil. Okay, right. So nowhere in the sum it is mentioned the 23 newton is in saturated condition. They have just used the word wet. They didn't use the word saturated. Okay, so please don't get confused. The given 23 newton may be the weight of soil in its saturated condition. Don't get confused like that. If it is saturated, they will clearly mention, or some they will use some indirect words like the soil is soaked. I won't say soaked. The soil is completely drenched in rain. Okay, they use some statements like that. Okay, but they have not used any statement like that here. So means it is wet, but it is not completely saturated. Okay, so please keep that in mind. So it is still in partial saturation condition. Okay, so don't get confused, like it may be there is the given data is saturated or not. Don't get confused like that. Okay, the given data is for partial saturation condition, that is bulk condition only. Okay, so gamma B, weight divided by volume. So here the weight is 23 newtons is the weight. Okay, so 23 into 10 power minus 3, just to convert the newton to kilonewton, we are using 10 power minus 3 divided by volume. It is 1150 centimeter cubes. So to convert the centimeter cube into meter cube, we are using the 10 power minus 6 term here. Okay, so put that, we will get 20 kilonewtons per meter cube. So now we can get why we have we are converting newtons into the kilonewtons and the centimeter cubes into meter cube. Okay, if you don't do that, we will get the number some large number here. Okay, so to reduce the number of digits, we are doing this. Okay, next, the dry unit weight part. So gamma D is expressed in WS divided by V, that is weight of solids only we are going to take into account. So weight of solids divided by water. So weight of solids here is 19.6. it is given in the problem itself. So 19.6 into 10 power minus 3 to convert newton into kilonewton divided by volume 1150 into 10 power minus 6, we get the answer 17.04 kilonewtons per meter cube. Okay, the next data, next required data is just a minute. Yeah, here the alternate way for calculating dry unit weight using some interrelationship instead of using the original relationship. If in case in the sum there is no dry weight of soil is given, okay, so if it is that case, how you can calculate gamma d? That is what given here. Okay, instead of using WS, we can alternatively calculate gamma d in this manner also. We will get the same answer. Okay, so in previous case, just see here, we are using the direct definition of dry unit weight. Okay, direct mathematical formula of dry unit weight, WS divided by V. But alternatively, if in your problem there is no WS given, there is no dry weight of soil is given, you can alternatively calculate it like this. Okay, from the bulk unit weight you can calculate the dry unit weight like this, provided you are given with the water content data. Okay, right, so gamma b divided by 1 plus w, to put all the data into account. So here you can see the water content w, they are putting the decimal version of water content here, not the percentage version. So actually in first subdivision we calculated the water content as 17.35, but we are substituting the value here as 0.1735. why I am insisting this is, nowadays in gate exam you are getting NET type questions, that is numerical answer type questions. If you are given with the multiple choice questions, then this won't affect you much. Okay, because you can guess the number. If you have done, in case you do any mistake, means even then you can pick the answer correctly by means of relating the choices given there and the answer you got in your calculator or in your calculation. Okay, but in case of numerical answer type questions, if you do your calculation wrongly and you put the value wrongly, you are not going to get answer, and there won't be any multiple choices available there to help you either. Okay, so please keep that in mind. Here we are substituting the decimal version of the water content, okay, in the formula. So for 17.35%, we are substituting it as 0.1735. okay, so you are getting the same answer which you got in your previous method also. Okay, 17.04 kilonewton per meter cube. Here also you are getting 17.04 kilonewton per meter cube. Right, now just look at the question. The fourth subdivision we were required the answer is saturated unit weight. Now we know two formulas to obtain the saturated unit weight. One is its base formula. Just a minute, I will write it in your screen, you can see it from there. So to get saturated unit weight, we have two different formulas. One is gamma sat equal to, sorry, weight of soil in its saturated condition, that is W bracket and then suffix sat divided by total volume. This is the basic formula for gamma sat. Another formula we are having is that interrelationship based formula, that is gamma sat is equal to G plus E into gamma W divided by 1 plus E. Okay, let's consider you have a very good memory of your formula while you are attending for your exam or even at this point. Let's consider you are very aware that you only have these two formulas to get this saturated unit rate. But unfortunately, if you look into the given data, we don't have all the variables we need or we need to insert in this formulas. Okay, so if you take the original version, that is gamma sat into gamma sat equal to weight of saturated soil divided by volume. We have volume here, okay, but we don't have the weight of soil in its saturated state, okay? So we cannot use this formula to calculate the gamma saturated. Okay, so okay, now I'm moving to the interrelationship category. Okay, let's see if I can solve the problem. Okay, now G plus E into gamma W divided by 1 plus E. Now, if you look into this formula, do I have G given in the problem? Yes, I have 2.65 given here as the specific gravity of the soil. So no problem with that. I have G here. Next, moving on to gamma W. Do we have gamma W here? Is it given in the problem? See, is it anywhere given in the problem? You can answer.
No.
No, but do you think they will give the unit weight of water in the problem itself? Actually, it is a standard value. So don't expect they will give that in the problem itself. Okay. So hope you can answer my question here. What is the unit weight of water?
1000 kilogram.
Yes, 1000 kilogram per meter cube. It is actually the density of water. Okay. Okay, oh, fair enough. You know the density of water. Then I hope you can obtain the unit weight from that value. Can you get it? So the density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. You know that. Okay. What I'm asking is, what is the unit weight? Can you get the unit weight from the density? Is it possible? It is very much possible, and we have already you could have done that in more than 3-4 courses, 3-4 papers all these years, all this previous 4 years. Conversion of density to unit weight, it is very, very simple. How can you do it? Converting the density into unit weight, you said the unit weight of the density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. Actually, you said as unit weight, but it is not unit weight. It is the density of water, 1000 kg per meter cube. What I'm asking is density. I'm sorry. What I'm asking is unit weight. Okay. So unit weight you have to express in what unit per kilonewtons per meter cube, right? Okay. But you are saying the value of water in density. Okay, that is the density of water. You are mentioning the density of water. That is kilogram per meter cube is density. Okay, we need unit weight. Very simple. Okay, so multiply the density with the acceleration due to gravity. So actually, this formula, we got this from Newton's law. Okay, force, Newton's force law, F is equal to M into A. So F is force that is expressed in kilonewton, which is equal to M into A, which denotes mass into acceleration due to gravity. Okay, so what you have mentioned is mass, 1000 kgs is mass. Okay, so you need force, kilonewton means what you have to do, multiply the mass with the acceleration due to gravity. So the next question I am posting here is, what is the acceleration due to gravity in Earth? Because it changes for every planet. Okay, so in Earth, what is the acceleration to gravity?
9.2 meter per second.
9.81. Okay, so 9.81, hope you know the unit for it, acceleration due to gravity. So what is the unit? 9.81?
Meter per second.
Meter per second is velocity's unit. So acceleration is actually velocity by time taken. So the unit is meter per second square. This is how you should arrive at the units. Okay, what you said is meter per second. It is actually the unit of speed or velocity. Okay, so speed in scalar units and velocity in vector units. Okay, I'm not going to get deep into that. That is engineering mechanics area. Just refreshing your units part. That's it. Okay, so you said a meter per second, but it is the unit of speed, not unit of acceleration. So acceleration is nothing but speed by time taken or velocity by time taken. Okay, so in that case, we will get another Yes, in the denominator part, that is meter per second square. So exactly, the acceleration due to gravity on Earth is 9.81 meter per second square. Okay, now coming to our case here. So you said the density of water is 1000 kg per meter cube. Now we convert that into unit weight. Very simple. Multiply the density with acceleration due to gravity, small g or a, whatever you term. Okay, as Newton said, that is F is equal to ma. You can call acceleration due to gravity as small a, or you can also use g as mentioned in some textbooks. Okay, what it's your wish. Okay, so multiply the density 1000 with 9.81. What you will get? 9810 newton per meter cube. If we convert that into kilonewton, the answer is 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. That is what we are looking for, looking here. Okay, gamma w. Please keep that in mind. In no problem, even in normal anionistry, we should not say normal anionistry because it is one of the leading technical universities. Just for a matter of fact, even in anionistry exams, we cannot expect gamma w to be given in the question paper. That is unit weight of water to be given in the question paper. Okay, usually they won't give the value, gamma w value, because it is a standard one as far as Earth. In Earth, the unit weight of water is 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. Please keep that in mind. Just like you had 1000 kg per meter cube in mind, please keep this also in your mind. 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube. They won't give that, or they won't mention that anywhere in the problem. Okay, so coming here, gamma set, the interrelationship is g plus e into gamma w divided by 1 plus e. Here g is given in the question itself, 2.65, and gamma w we know. Maybe after this, we know gamma W as 9.81. So we are left with E. Do we know void ratio or else it is given in the question itself? No. Nowhere it is mentioned void ratio, the value of void ratio in the question. Actually, we are asked to answer or asked to calculate the void ratio in the question. Okay, see subdivision number 6. Okay, we are required to calculate the void ratio. Okay, so we are left here, okay, unclosed, or we are left here with some unknown data to solve the gamma set. So what we are going to do is skip this fourth subdivision, saturated unit weight division, and we are going to move to the next subdivision, that is effective unit weight subdivision. Here I have another problem here. Okay, so what is effective unit weight? As per our definitions, effective unit weight is nothing but submerged unit weight. Okay, so actually submerged unit weight formula is gamma sat minus gamma w. To calculate the submerged unit weight or effective unit weight, in the first place I need to know the value of saturated unit weight. That itself I don't know here, right? Okay, I don't know the saturated unit weight itself, then how can I calculate the submerged unit weight? Okay, so coming to our problem, subdivision 4 and subdivision 5, I cannot calculate at this moment. Okay, so I'm moving to the next one, void ratio. Is it possible for me to calculate void ratio? I have to check it, then I can proceed with the sum. Okay, so for void ratio, I am left with two formulas, the basic void ratio formula and a interrelationship. There are multiple interrelationships for void ratio actually. We can discuss that one by one. Okay, so first, the basic void ratio formula is E is equal to, do you remember that? E is equal to VV by VS. So this is the basic void ratio formula. If you look into the sum, we are provided with the total volume data, but nowhere in the sum they have given the proportions of the volume of voids or the volume of solids anywhere in the problem. We are only provided with the total volume, capital V. They have not given any split up for VV or VS or anything else for that matter. Okay, so we cannot use this formula right now. Okay, so we cannot use this. Now, moving on to any other interrelationship we know about void ratio is, the first one is going to be E is equal to N divided by 1 plus N. Okay, that is porosity. N is nothing but porosity here. So we are provided, or we are given with another interrelationship here. That is E is equal to N divided by 1 plus N. Here, N is the porosity. Okay, so, well, we don't know the value of porosity 2. So we cannot use this interrelationship also. Okay, now I have to move to some other interrelationship or modify some other interrelationship to get the value of E here. Okay, so please keep in mind as a shortcut here this particular step. Okay, it will be very, very useful for most of the cases. Okay, please keep this as a shortcut for calculating the value of E. So because most of the times, even in university exams as well as the competitive exams, you may need to find E in order to calculate any property that involves E. You can see in this particular problem itself, the value, void ratio value is useful in how many property calculation stages you will make use of E. Okay, just look into this. This is how you can get the E indirectly. Okay, we have an interrelationship for gamma D. That is G into gamma W. G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E. We have an interrelationship like this. G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E. If we look into this interrelationship, we have all the variables, that is the values of all the variables except E. So you can calculate the value of E from this formula. Actually, in most of the problems involving or finding out E, you can check this formula or give this formula the first priority. Mostly, you can calculate the value of E from this formula. Okay, because usually everyone will keep in mind these two formulas which I have already mentioned here. That is E's basic formula, void ratio's basic formula, VV by VS, and E's relationship with the porosity. Only these two formulas will come into mind for most of the students or even candidates, you can say, okay, while they are appearing for exam. They will forget about this interrelationship while calculating the value of E. So please keep in mind and give this formula a first go. In most of the cases, you will end up getting the value of E from here. Okay, just look into this. We are going to modify this formula so that we can get the value of E like this. Here, from gamma D, that is the interrelationship of gamma D, see here, the second line. Okay, so from gamma D, that is G into gamma W divided by 1 plus E interrelationship, we can get E like this, just a cross multiplication, nothing else. Okay, so take this 1 plus E here and gamma D here. Okay, take 1 plus E to the numerator and gamma D to the denominator of the right side. So again, from that 1 plus E, take the 1 to the right hand side. You will get, or you will modify the formula to this state. Okay, from here to here. Okay, modify the formula like this. G into gamma W divided by gamma D minus 1. Modify the formula like this. Now you will know, you know all the values of the variables in this formula. Okay. So we know G as 2.65. Gamma W, it is not given in the question, but it is a constant value. We know that 9.81. And gamma D, we have calculated the value of gamma D in the second step. Third subdivision. And as 17.04, substitute those values in the formula. We get the void ratio as 0.526. Okay, so straight away solving the first three subdivisions, after solving the first three subdivisions, we skipped subdivision 4 and 5 because we are left with some unknown variables. So we left those two steps and we jumped to the sixth subdivision and solved the value of void ratio. Now go to subdivision 4, see or check whether you can solve the saturated unit rate value. Now it is very much easy for us to solve the value of saturated unit rate. Actually, I have done that in the last step, but not a problem. Okay, just look into this. After finding E value, you can go here. Okay, so see the formula G plus E into gamma W divided by 1 plus E. So now, actually, while we are discussing about solving this subdivision, that is fourth subdivision in the first place, we were left with E being unknown. Now we know the value of E, so substitute the value here, you will get the saturated unit rate value as 20.42 kilonewton per meter cube. So after calculating saturated unit weight, go for fifth subdivision, that is asked in the question, effective unit weight, calculate that too. Okay, very simple. Effective unit weight is otherwise called as submerged unit weight, gamma sub or gamma dash. Actually, there are many other names for effective unit weight. One being submerged unit weight, okay. Another one being buoyant unit weight, okay. You can call all these three names, okay. Either effective unit weight or submerged unit weight or buoyant unit weight. All three denote the same property of the soil, okay. So please don't get confused. All three denotes the same. Okay, just keep that in mind. So to calculate this property, I have to simply subtract the saturated unit weight with the unit weight of water. Okay, so gamma sat minus gamma W, we will get the value 10.61 here, the last step. Okay, so in the problem, we have solved subdivision 4 and subdivision 5 in this manner. While dealing a problem, sometimes you will end up calculating a property which may not been asked in the first place. Say for example, in this problem, if you are provided with the bulk unit weight value, okay, so the dry unit weight value and so on, okay, and you are asked to answer the saturated unit weight and submerged unit weight alone, okay. So this is the original question. Please assume if this is the question given to you. You are given the values of bulk unit weight. You have given provided with the values of dry unit weight of the soil, and you are asked to or you are supposed to answer the values of saturated and the submerged unit weight. Okay, you cannot do that directly. Okay, you may end up calculating void ratio in the midway of the problem. Okay, so please don't keep in mind that we will be simply given some given data. We can directly calculate the required data from the given data. Okay, so sometimes you may need to cross a property which is not given in the question itself. Okay, sometimes you may need to do that. Okay, so this is a big complication in solving this. That is why most of the people think this subject is some kind of a vague or some very, very difficult subject. Okay, so you may need to find the value of a property which is not mentioned anywhere in the question, either in the given data part or required data part, but you may need to cross that property somewhere in the problem while solving the problem. Okay, so please keep that in mind. Okay, the next, we are left with answering porosity and degree of saturation. We need to answer that. So the porosity is n is equal to e divided by 1 plus e. So what is that? So who is that? Please switch off your mic. Number 67, please switch off your mic. I'm getting disturbed. Sounds here. Number 67, please switch off your mic. number 23, can you call him and tell it?
I don't have his number, sir. It's other class.
Okay, okay, I will inform you, sir. I can't, it's distracting too much. Just a minute. I'll call your faculty and ask him to switch off his mic. Just a minute.
अब खत्म करता है यार सीरियसली
और else you please switch off his audio
like this ओ बेबी तेरा जान से प्यारा ओ बेबी मैं लिस्ट
like this please switch off his audio number 23 please switch off his audio like I did just now can you do it shall I proceed Shall I proceed? I switched off the audio.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. Let's switch off the audio. Let's proceed. Okay. Next one, a porosity. You can calculate from the interrelationship E divided by 1 plus E. So from this, sorry, minus N. Actually, this is E divided by 1 minus N. Okay, right. Right. So porosity, you can calculate like this: E divided by 1 plus E. Like this one, right? So E by 1 plus E, so 0.526 divided by 1 plus 0.526, we will get the answer 34.4%. Okay, so the finally, the degree of saturation, yes, you can calculate from the formula WG divided by E. So what component? We know it, G, it is given in the question itself. E, we have calculated a step before. So substitute all those values, 0.1735 multiplied by 2.65 divided by 0.526, you will get the value of degree of saturation as 0.874. Multiply that with 100, you will get the answer 87.4%. Okay, so this is how you need to solve problems. Okay, so in this problem, we were given with four given data, and we are supposed to answer or supposed to calculate a total of 8 properties. We did that all. Okay, so one thing I need to give a fact here or note here. So it is a very, very important one. Sometimes you may get question in this fact or note. Just look into the values of unit weights in this problem. I will list all those values. Okay, so we can see I will list all those values. You can see how the unit weights are varying. Just a minute. Do we have any empty slide here? Yes. Okay. So I'm left with two slides. Okay. That will be useful for me. Okay. Just a minute. Okay, so totally in this problem, we calculated four different unit weights. Number one, is gamma B. Number two is gamma D, dry unit weight. Number three is gamma sat. Number 4 is gamma dash. That is effective. Okay. Totally, we solved 4 different unit weights in this problem. Just look into the values we obtained here. First one, gamma B, we got 1T. For gamma D, we got 17.04. 20 kilonewton per meter cube. 17.04 kilonewton per meter cube. Gamma sat, we got 20.42 kilonewton per meter cube. And for gamma dash, we got 10.61. Okay, so just compare all these 4 values. Okay, so now you get a clear idea for a same soil how the unit weights are getting arranged. The least is going to be the effective unit weight gamma dash. Okay, and then the dry unit weight, and then the bulk unit weight, and then the saturated unit weight. Sometimes questions may come like arrange the unit weights for a same soil. Okay, so for the same given soil, the heavier unit weight it is going to be in its saturated state. Okay, the unit weight of soil is going to be in its saturated, the maximum unit weight of the soil is going to be in its saturated state, and the next second maximum it is going to be in its bulk state, and the third one dry state, since all the water is going to get removed from the solid particles, and the area or the volume occupied by the water is going to get occupied by the air, which is much lighter when comparing to the water. So thereby the entire unit weight is going to take a hit there. Okay, so that's why comparing to the bulk and saturated unit weights, the dry unit weight is lesser. Okay, you can see that in the problem itself, the answers we obtained in the problem itself. Okay, and the last one, the least or the minimum unit weight, it is going to be in its submerged state. Okay, so we can take the practical phenomenon which we were taught during our school days here. If object is immersed or submerged in water, its weight is going to get reduced. It is because of the buoyancy present or buoyant force which is going to be applied on the object. Okay, the same thing is going to happen with the soil also. That is why even though the soil is completely saturated, as I already said, for a soil to attain a submerged condition, first it has to pass through the saturated condition. Okay, the soil will get submerged only when all the voids get filled with water, then only it can settle down in a water. Okay, right? So even though the soil is completely saturated, the weight, the submerged weight is very much less. It is because of this buoyancy factor. Okay, so please don't get confused why the saturated weight of soil is much higher, but for a submerged soil it is also saturated, but why its weight is not higher. Okay, so please keep this in mind. So in a submerged soil, there will be a negative buoyancy force, upward buoyancy force will be there. Okay, so which is acting in the opposite direction of our natural gravity force, opposite direction to our natural gravity, and hence the weight is going to get reduced. So please keep this order in mind. Okay, for the same soil, this is the order in weight in which the unit weights will be. Okay, the much higher unit weight will be for the saturated soil, and the much lower unit weight will be for the submerged soil. Please keep that in mind. Okay, right. Moving on to the next problem. Okay, right. What's the time? 1840. Okay, 6:40. Right. Moving on to the next problem. A natural soil deposit. Actually, this problem, I think it was asked in GATE a few years back. A natural soil deposit has a bulk unit weight of 19 kilonewtons per meter cube and a water content of 5%. Estimate the amount of water required to be added to 1 meter cube of the soil to raise the water content to 15%. Assume the void ratio to remain constant. The specific gravity of solids is 2.67. Okay. As I already said in the previous problem itself, please extract the given data stage by stage. So, the first statement, what it is given, a natural soil deposit has a bulk unit weight. So, the given data is gamma B. Clearly, they have used the word bulk here. So, you can take without any confusions, gamma B as 19 kiloton per meter cube and water content as 5%. Here, we have to say this 5% as natural water content, because in its natural state, a natural soil deposit, they have used the natural word in the first place. But only at the end of the statement, they have given water content. So you have to connect like this. Okay. So natural water content is 5%. Okay. So estimate the amount of water required to be added to 1 meter cube of the soil. Which soil? Here. This one. This 19 kilonewton per meter cube unit weight soil. Okay, they are mentioning that one. So that natural deposit soil. Okay. So for 1 meter cube of that natural deposit, how much water you need to add in order to raise the water content to 15%? From where? It's natural water content 5%. That way you have to understand this question. Okay. So actually the original or the natural water content of the deposit is 5%. I have to increase it to 15%. Okay. So for that, how much water I need to add? So this is the question. Okay. So I'm just putting the words in some order to make the question in or to understand the question in a much simpler way. That's it. Nothing else. Okay. In this way, you try to face any problem. Okay. So any numerical problem in any subject, try to put the words so that you can understand it in a much better way, but please don't change the context of the question. Okay, so please keep that in mind. Right, moving on to the question. Assume the void ratio to remain constant. Okay, so the specific gravity of solids is 2.67. there is g value, it is given. Okay, now listening out the given data, so bulk unit weight gamma b 19 kiloton per meter cube. So natural water content, we can call it as stage one, okay, or initial stage. Okay, so from that stage we are going to increase the water content to the second stage 15%. Okay, so I'm naming here, I'm keeping the names as W1 and W2 for 5% and 15% respectively. You can keep some other names also, like from stage A to stage B, you can keep it as WA, WB, like that also. Okay, but for a better understanding, I have used the numbers here. W1, that is for a step or stage one or initial stage as W1, and the final stage as W2. So W1 is 5%, W2 is 15%, and the volume here, they haven't given the volume, the total volume of the natural deposit, but we don't need that anyway. Okay. What we need is, for 1 meter cube, how much we need to add water, how much water we need to add. That's what we need. So just we can keep the volume here as 1 meter cube. So you no need to think why they have given, they haven't given the total volume of the deposit and all. You don't need that anyway. Okay, right. The specific gravity value G is 2.67. Okay, so these are the given data. Okay, next, dry unit. From this, I am going to calculate the dry unit weight of the soil, because for calculating water content in the previous sum itself, just to recall, just look at this formula. So water content we can calculate from this formula, weight of water by weight of solids. In this problem, in the second problem, I'll write the formula at the right side, so no need to go back and forth. So water content, it is usually expressed in weight of water by weight of solids, water content small w. Okay, so here I am given with the data w here, it is given here. Okay, what they have asked here is the water, the amount of water required. That is, they are asking WW here. What they are looking for is WW. Okay, we have to find this. Okay, we are provided with this information. Okay, we have to find this. So in order to find this, first place we need to find this. That is what we are doing here. So to find the WS, we have to think in which property we are using the weight of solids apart from this water property. Okay, for in dry unit weight of the soil, we use WS divided by V. For calculating dry unit weight, we use this formula. V is this term, WS by V. So from there, you can calculate the WS value. Okay, so we are going to travel like this in this problem. Okay, so what I need is WW. So WW I can get from WS and W. Okay, so in this W is already given. So to find WS, okay, I have to find gamma D. So from where I can get gamma D? From gamma B I can get gamma D. This is how you are going to travel in the sum. Okay, so looking the problem in a single sheet, you may think it is a very simple one, but when you go to an exam hall after reading this question, they won't, you will feel blank, nothing else. Okay, so don't think it is a very simple problem. Actually, it is not. Right? So please keep that in mind. So this is how we are going to travel in this problem. So from bulk unit weight, we are going to get dry unit weight. From dry unit weight, we are going to get weight of solids. From weight of solids, we are going to get calculate the weight of water. That is what I actually asked in the question. Okay, right. So this is how we are going to travel. So first step, calculating the dry unit weight part, because the bulk unit weight is already given in the question. So we are calculating the dry unit weight part from this relationship between the bulk and the dry unit weights. So gamma B divided by 1 plus W, we get 19 divided by 1 plus 0.05, which is equal to 18.095 kilonewton per meter cube. We get the answer 18.095 kilonewton per meter cube. As I already said in the previous problem, you can check here also. Comparing to the bulk unit weight, the dry unit weight value is less. Okay, that is what we have discussed here also. Here too. Look at this. Gamma D is less than gamma B. Okay, same thing here also. Okay, so the bulk unit weight is 19, but the dry unit weight is only 18.095, almost 0.9 kilonewtons per meter cube lesser one. Okay, there is approximately 900 newtons. Okay, it's not a smaller value. Okay, right. Coming to the problem. So once we are we have calculated, once we calculated gamma d, then moving on to WS. So weight of dry soil WS is equal to, we can calculate from here. You know the basic formula, gamma d is equal to WS divided by V. Cross multiplying it, we get gamma d multiplied by W. I'm sorry, V. Okay. This is the basic formula. Gamma d is equal to WS by V. We have used this formula in previous problem also. Okay. So first you have to be well versed with this soil mechanics basic formulas. Then only you can think about solving this problem itself. Okay. So please keep that in mind. But it is going to be a major share in GATE exams. The soil mechanics subject is going to get a major share, around 15% of the marks. Okay, so there is nothing wrong in putting more efforts to study this paper, in my view. Okay, right. So gamma d equal to WS plus P. From this formula, this step we have read to this step. So cross multiplying. So WS is equal to gamma d into V. Okay. So 18.905 into 1. 18.905 kilonewton. That is weight. So next, weight of water at 5%. So WW1 is equal to W1 into D. That is the original water content formula here. Look here. Okay. Small W is equal to WW divided by WS. That formula we are coming here. So W into WD. So you can see WS or WD, whatever term denotes the soil part. That's it, nothing else. So dry weight of solids alone, we are giving the term WS or WD. So D denotes dry soil, or WS denotes weight of solids. Both are same. No need to get confused. Okay. So in dry soil, the weight is going to be contributed by solids part alone. Okay, that's it, nothing else. So W1 into WD. Okay, so original condition, the weight of water, it is going to be 5 by 100 into 18.905. We will get the answer 0.905 kilonewtons. So which means in 18.095, 0.905 of the soil is, 0.905 of the weight of the soil is contributed by water. That is what we are calculating here. For weight of water at 15%, we will get it as 2.714 kilonewtons. So subtracting both this, we will get the total weight of water to be added to raise the water content to 15%. Okay. Right. So we are calculating the water content at 5% and the water content at 15%. So by means of subtracting those two conditions, we will get how much water need to be added. That's what we have done here. Okay. So 2.714 is water content, or the weight of water at 15%, and 0.905 is the weight of water at 5% of water content. So subtracting these two, we will get 1.809 kilonewton. So the answer is, in terms of weight, the answer is 1.809 kilonewton. Okay. If in case they require the answer in terms of volume, can calculate the volume in this manner. Okay. So from unit weight formula, there is unit weight of water, gamma W is equal to weight of water by volume of water. So from this formula, if you need volume of water, you can cross multiply it like this. So VWD is equal to WW divided by gamma W, which is equal to 1.809 divided by 9.81 is equal to 0.1844 meter cube. multiplied it by 1000 because in 1 meters 1000 liters is 1 meter equals 1000 liters. So 1 meter cube is equal to 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liters. So here I have 0.1844 meter cube. So multiply it with 1000, you will get this answer, 184.4 liters. Okay, so we have to keep this small basic conversions into mind. Okay, right. So 1 meter cube is equal to 1000 liters. You might have come across this conversion in fluid mechanics itself. You may have come across. I'm not saying you might have definitely come across that, but just a minute. Point 4 watts. Okay, that problem I have kept at the last, I think. Okay, a soil sampler, the next problem. Again, this is a gate question. A soil sampler of volume 1000 centimeter cube is used to collect soil samples. It was found that sampler contained 2 kg soil with dry unit weight of 1800 kg per meter cube. If 300 grams of water is mixed to the soil, then what will be the water content of the sample? Okay, so actually it's a quite simple problem. Again, this problem, it was asked in GATE. I don't know exactly the year. This problem is discussed in MADEC GATE classes too. Okay. Just to extract the data, a soil sampler of volume 1000 centimeter cube, that is capital V, 1000 centimeter cube. It was found that the sampler contained 2 kg soil, that is capital W, you can call it as capital W, with a dry unit weight of 1800 kg per meter cube. Okay, so dry unit weight means gamma D is 1800 kg per meter cube is gamma D, right? If 300 grams of water, what is that WW? Okay, so grams of water weight, here they have mentioned 300 grams of water, means they are denoting the weight of water. Don't think all the time they may call or give the value of water in liters or milliliters like that. Okay, sometimes they may give it in grams or kgs, like the way it is given here. 300 grams of water is mixed to the soil, then what will be the water content of the sample? So what they are expecting as the answer is small w. So what is the small w when the sample is mixed with 300 grams of water? That is what they have asked here. Okay, let's see how we are going to solve this. Okay, so first, from the gamma d value, okay, so the gamma d value 1800 kg per meter cube, let's calculate the weight of solids, because as I already said in the previous problem, to calculate the water content, I need to calculate the weight of solids and I need the weight of solids and the weight of water to calculate here. Look here. Okay, so to calculate the water content, I need these two parameters, weight of water and the weight of solids. Okay, so that is what I am doing here. So first place, I am calculating the weight of solids. Okay, so gamma d is equal to ws is equal to gamma d multiplied by v. Okay, so from the base formula, I am calculating this. So gamma d is ws by v. So from this, I am calculating this, cross multiplying. Okay, right. Actually, I need ws, so I am multiplying gamma d with the volume so that I will get the weight of solids around. Okay, so that's what I am doing here. Coming to gamma d, it is given in meter cube, but the volume is given in centimeter cube. So I am converting the centimeter cube into meter cube by multiplying 10 power minus 6 as I did in my first problem. Okay, so 1000 into 10 power minus 6, that is the volume, and then it is multiplied with the unit weight 1800. I am getting the answer 1.8 kg. Okay, so that is the weight of the soil, dry weight of the soil, but the actual weight of the soil is 2 kgs. It is given in the first statement of the question. It was found that the sampler containing 2 kg of soil. What this means here? The actual weight is 2 kgs, but the dry weight is 1.8 kgs. What this means here? What does it denote? What does it denote? It's only here. Two people are in the class. What does it denote? So actually, the actual weight of soil is 2 kgs, but through mathematical calculations, I have found that the dry weight is 1.8 kgs, which means the difference 0.2 kgs, it is of water. Okay. So the weight of water before mixing additional water, that is, we can term it as the natural water content. Already there is a 0.2 kg of water present in the soil naturally. Okay, so you have to take that into account. Okay, so the original weight is 2 kg, and then from the sample or from the soil sample, by doing tests and calculations, I have found the dry weight of the soil as 1.8 kg. So from that, I have found that the natural water content of the soil as, or natural way, or the weight of natural water present in the soil as 0.2 kgs, right? So that is what I have written here, weight of water before mixing additional water. Okay, so 2 minus 1.8, we get 0.2 kgs. So even before mixing the 300 grams of water, there is already 0.2 kgs, that is 200 grams of water is present in the soil naturally. Okay, now coming to the point. After mixing 300 grams of water, now the total weight of water which is going to be in the soil is 0.5 kgs. Okay, so 0.2 plus 0.3 will get 0.5 kgs. Okay, right. Now calculate the water content. So thus, water content small w is equal to ww divided by ws into 100%. So solve it, we will get 0.5 divided by 1.8, that is weight of solids, as we have calculated here. Okay, so 0.5 divided by 1.8 multiplied by 100, we will get 27.8%. Okay, so in the sum, you can also calculate the natural water content of the soil. How? So 0.2, if you take this 0.2 alone, 0.2 divided by 1.8, you may calculate, you can be able to calculate the natural water content of the soil. So just for instance, let's do it. So 0.2 divided by 1.8. So 11.11. Okay. So 0.111 means 11.11 if you multiply by 100. Okay. So 11.11%. So that was the natural water content of the soil before mixing this or before adding this 0.3. Or 300 grams of water. So before adding this 300 grams of water, the natural water content of the soil was 11.11%. Okay, actually that was not asked in the problem, just for our clarification we just checked that here. Nothing else. Actually that was not asked in the problem. You don't need to worry about that, but to get an idea calculate that. So the natural water content was 11.11%. So after adding 300 grams, the water content is getting increased to 27.8%. Please keep that in mind. That's it. The next one, another definition, relative density or density index. I want you to make one thing clear here. In fluid mechanics, relative density means what? Do you know that? In fluid mechanics, actually, relative density denotes some other parameter. Do you remember that?
No, sir.
Actually, in fluid mechanics, specific gravity can also be called as relative density. Okay. So now you please keep that in mind. In fluid mechanics, for specific gravity, you can call another term, that is relative density. Okay, we can either use relative density or specific gravity. But here in soil mechanics, these two terms are completely different. Specific gravity is something else, that is in comparison with the standard fluid, how much the fluid which we have or how much the solid we have in hand weighs. Okay, so that is what the meaning of specific gravity. That's the same meaning applies in fluid mechanics also. Okay, but in relay, as far as relative density is concerned, in fluid mechanics, relative density has the same definition of a specific gravity. But here, relative density has a completely different meaning. Okay, so this is a definition of relative density or density index. You can call it as either relative density or density index. Actually, this term, this terminology is applicable mostly, or it is used mostly for coarse grained soils, means sand or gravel. So sandy or gravelly soils, for those soils we use this term more often. For clayey soils, we usually don't prefer using relative density. We use some other term. We will see that in next slides or next sessions maybe. Okay, so for instance, the relative density terminology, we use this for coarse grained soils, means either sandy soil or gravelly soils. Okay, let's look into the definition. The degree of denseness or looseness of natural deposits of coarse grained soils can be measured in terms of relative density. So relative density, it is defined as the ratio of difference between void ratio of a cohesionless soil in its loosest state and void ratio in its natural states to the difference between its void ratio in the loosest state, that is E max again, and its densest state E minimum. Okay, just let me put this into practical terminologies. Okay, so for a dense soil, how the void ratio is going to be? For a highly dense soil, the number of voids present is going to be very, very less. thereby the void ratio is going to be very, very less. Okay, so that's why here look into the statement. The void ratio. Look into this last word, densest state. That is the soil, the same soil in its densest condition. That is most compacted condition. The void ratios are going to be very, very less. The number of voids are going to be very, very less, and hence we are using the term E minimum. But in its loosest state, just let's say you are just spreading the soil in the floor, the number of voids is going to be very, very more, very, very high, and in that case, the void ratio is going to be maximum, E max. Two terms, and the third term is the void ratio in its natural state, E nat. Okay, so this is the mathematical formula of a density index or relative density, E max minus E natural divided by E max minus E minimum. Okay, so we will express the relative density in terms of percentage, and hence we are multiplying with 100 here. Okay, here it is a small table which denotes actually this is a quantitative value of classifying the soil on the basis of relative density. Okay, so if the relative density is very, very less, you can term the soil as a very, very loose one, say less than 15. Okay, the relative density value is less than 15, you can call the soil as a very loose one, and for a highly dense soil, the relative density can be more than 100 also. Okay, you can't limit that to 100, it can be more than 100 also. Okay, right. Next, 15 to 35, the soil is loose condition, 35 to 65 medium condition, 65 to 85 dense condition. If it is 100 or more, you can call it as a very dense soil. Actually, yep, very dense soil. Okay, now moving on to a problem. Find the relative density of a sand whose maximum, minimum, and natural dry unit weights. Okay, let me underline that here. Dry unit weights are 18 kilonewton per meter cube, 15 kilonewton per meter cube, and 16.5 kilonewton per meter cube, respectively. Okay, so they have given the dry unit weights in three states: maximum, minimum, and dry states. I'm sorry, maximum, minimum, and natural states. And they have asked the value of relative density of the sand. Okay, we know the relative density formula is given in terms of void ratios, but the given data here is not void ratios. Instead, they have given the dry unit weights of the soil. Okay, so we are provided with a totally different set of data. Okay, not the data we were expecting. We are expecting the void ratios to be given, because that is what actually given in the that is how the formula is actually derived. But here we are provided with the unit weights, not the void ratios. Now, what I have to do? Actually, you can do two things here. Either you can calculate the void ratios from the given dry unit weights. That is one step. You can calculate the E max values, E natural values, and E minimum values from the given dry unit weights, and you can proceed with the original formula like this. That is one method. Another method is you can change the formula itself. You can modify the formula itself. Instead of void ratios, you can change the formulas in terms of dry unit weights like this. That is also possible. You can change the formula like this, and you can substitute the values given in the question and solve the problem. Again, proceed the sum in this two fashions. Okay, hope you can understand. Either you can calculate the void ratios from the given dry unit weights, or you can convert the formula itself two dry unit weight terms. Instead of wall ratio terms, you can convert the pharma itself into dry unit weight terms and to solve the problems. Okay. But for doing both the things, we are going to use the same base pharma, which I have mentioned to you a couple of problems before. This one, gamma D equal to G gamma W divided by 1 plus E. I asked you to remember this formula because it will be useful in finding E in most of the cases. Okay. So how this is getting converted? So E is equal to G gamma W by gamma D minus 1. This is what we have seen in that first problem that we discussed in this session. Okay. So what you can do is, from this formula, you can calculate the void ratios for all the three states, maximum, minimum, and natural state. Okay. And then you can substitute the values here in this original ID formula. You can do that thing, or else you can substitute the formula, that is the void ratio formula itself, into this expression, and you can modify this expression and create a new form expression from it like this. Okay. You can do both the things, but you have to keep one thing in mind. The void ratio, it is going to be maximum for which state? Maximum dry unit weight or minimum dry unit weight? The void ratio is going to be maximum for the minimum dry unit weight condition. Okay. The soil has maximum void ratio, then the weight of the soil is going to be very less. Okay. Both the terms are inversely proportional. Okay. So what students usually, the usual mistake students does is, to find out E max, they will put gamma D max as a given data here in this formula, and they will proceed the sum. But actually it is wrong, because the void ratio and dry unit weight are inversely proportional. You can see in this formula also, E is equal to G into gamma W divided by gamma D. They are inversely proportional. You can see here. Okay. Right. That's what I'm saying in my statement. So for calculating E max, you have to put gamma D minimum in the formula. And for calculating E minimum, you have to put gamma D max in the formula. Okay. So by that method, we can calculate all E max, E minimum, and for E natural, that is not going to be a problem. Natural dry unit weight of the soil, you put into the formula, you will get the natural void ratio. That's it. That's not going to confuse you in any way. But the for calculating the maximum and minimum void ratios, you have to substitute the inverse, substitute their inverse dry unit weight counterparts. Okay. So please keep that in mind. So you can calculate in that way. Calculate E max, E minimum, and E natural, substitute in this formula, and you can get the answer, or else you can calculate like this. You can change the formula itself. How I have done this here, just look into this. I'll show you. So the original formula is ID equal to E max minus E natural divided by E max minus E minimum. Okay. So instead of E max, I am substituting G into gamma W divided by gamma D minus 1. So here gamma D is, for maximum void ratio, I have to substitute minimum gamma D. Okay. Similarly, for E natural, G into gamma W divided by gamma D natural minus 1. Substitute the denominator in the same manner. G gamma W divided by gamma D max minus 1 I'm sorry, gamma d max not, gamma d minimum only. For e max, you have to substitute minimum. Here, for calculating e minimum, I have to substitute g into gamma w by gamma d max. So calculating, for calculating max, yeah, sorry, for calculating minimum, e minimum, you have to substitute the maximum dry unit weight. In maximum dry unit weight condition, the void ratio is going to be minimum. Okay, so all these terms you can take out g into gamma w minus 1 commonly, and you can calculate, cancel the numerator and the denominator terms. You will get the formula in this nature: 1 by gamma d minimum minus 1 by gamma d natural divided by 1 by gamma d minimum minus 1 by gamma d max. Okay, so you have converted this formula or converted or modified this formula into this state, and you are substituting the original given values here. We'll get the answer 54.5%. You can do in either of this method, whichever way it is convenient for you, you can do that. Okay, it's not a big problem, but only thing is, please keep that in mind, for finding the maximum void ratio, you have to substitute the minimum dry unit weight. They are inversely proportional. Please keep that in mind. Please think practically. For a soil to have more weight, the voids should be much lesser in the soil. That's it, nothing else. Okay, to increase to have a more unit weight soil, the voids should be less than that. That's it. Okay, right. So I think with this problem can complete the session, because the next two topics are related to clay soils. We can discuss that in the next class. If you have any doubts, you can post in the discussion forum. Or else we can.
No, no, sir.